dance, baby.
Welcome back to Good Morning Football Week.
They're always rolling, man. I don't know what it was.
There is Gillette Stadium there, the Patriots locker room, as they get ready to host the Chargers
last
today.
Time right there, 87?
I don't know. I wonder. There's Edelman's jersey. We'll see. They've been really good at home this entire season, but only team that went undefeated in the regular season at home at Foxborough. But yes, we know the Chargers are really good on the road, too. Rivers and Brady, a combined 357 career wins. All eyes will be on them today, but our eyes now are on Omar Ruiz and Mike Giardi. Omar, what do you have on the Chargers this morning?
Well, second game in a row, they have some familiarity. Traveling on a Friday to the East Coast, second game in a row, playing at 10 a.m., their body clock time. On Sunday, what is different is the quarterback they're preparing for. Not only stylistically are Lamar Jackson and Tom Brady different, but they now go from preparing for the youngest quarterback to ever start a playoff matchup since the merger to now facing the oldest and most experienced. Anthony Lynn telling me that what makes Tom Brady's experience show up is how he gets rid of the football so quickly. He can negate a pass rush single-handedly. Rookie linebacker Chenna Nwosa said the key to slowing down this Patriots offense isn't Tom Brady. It's attacking his linemen. It's attacking his weapons. That's how you affect Tom Brady, who at this point in his career has seen it all. For more now on the Patriots, let's send it over to Mike Giardi.
Thank you, Omar. Jason McCourty, Patriots cornerback, said Philip Rivers has the it factor. He's just one of those guys. He makes special plays all game long. Patriots have talked about the need to disguise things, and obviously Rivers has been in the league so long that that's not easy to do, but Bill Belichick cautioned, you don't want to sit in just one thing, because if you do that, he'll pick you apart. When I was talking to Devin McCourty, he said one of the things that makes Rivers very difficult to defend is the fact that if he sees just a little step for one of his receivers, he's going to put the ball up there and make it. He said he's not one of those guys that's going to force feed one receiver. He goes to the guy that's open, Colleen.
Yeah, Mike, you can't give him anything at all, not even an inch. We'll see what happens. Mike, thank you, and Omar as well. Stay warm out there. All the talk, too, guys, about Brady showing signs of decline, well, the numbers tell a different story. Your eyes might see something different on tape, but this is what the numbers say. His production this season, right on pace with his last two Super Bowl seasons, nearly identical in completion percentage, passing yards, and yards per attempt. Though he has been off on a lot of throws that he would normally make, which is kind of weird to see. But, Steve, how much success do you expect the Patriots offense to have today against the Chargers defense?
Well, I'm going to say what everybody else is afraid to say. What offense? I mean, this offense is struggling a little bit when Gronk is not healthy, right? And then you just lost Flash Gordon. Josh Gordon, where is he at? He's not available to go. This team was not prepared to have Gronk not be 100%, Josh Gordon not be there. They can't just manufacture an offense. Mike Robb used this phrase with Andy Reid. Josh McDaniels is a great coordinator, but you only as good as your players. And if you don't have any players, you can't allow Sony Michel to be the answer to all your woes. Putting him, lining him outside, running screens. He has the ability to do only so much. He's still a rookie. So I'm just not sure if this offense can show up because it's not that they can't. They just lack some players to do it.
Yeah, they do lack some players. And if they don't block Joey Bosa and Melvin Ingram, this game is over before it even started. I mean, these guys are game records. You saw what Melvin Ingram did last week against the Baltimore Ravens. 7 tackles, 4 pressures, and 2 sacks on only 51 snaps. He made every single rep very valuable. And then Joey Bosa, 6.5 sacks since week 12 or something like that. He seems like he's getting his legs up underneath him. These guys are game wreckers, and both of them demand double teams, and it'll be impossible to double team both of them. And what I love is when they get into that nickel package and put those guys over the guards. Guards aren't used to pass protecting all the time, especially against elite pass rushers. And I think if the Los Angeles Chargers, they want to win this game, these two guys have to affect Tom Brady.
And then you got Gronk, who hasn't been the Gronk that we've seen.
No.
He's battled through some physical stuff. That's why Ian Rappaport talked earlier about the possibility of him retiring after this game or after this playoff run, whatever may come here. To me, Derwin James is the guy that can do
superstar.
A little bit of everything. He's phenomenal. He can be physical. He can run a little bit. He can do a lot of things. So are those two guys going to get matched up today? And what's that going to look like? You see him against some tight ends here. I think that's a fantastic matchup. The young guard against the older guy. Let's see who can win that matchup when those two are locked up. Usually Gronk will see a bunch of different guys because they line them up everywhere. They're motioning all those kinds of things. But I want to see what Derwin James can do.
And also be on the lookout for Derwin James around the line of scrimmage. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is speed when this guy blitzes now, and there's not a lot of backs or offensive linemen that will be able to take care of him.
Also, sometimes with weather, they're talking about will weather be a factor? It will be a factor in this regard. If you have a tight back, a tight hamstring, mm-hmm. ankle, whatever you have going on, 20 degrees is going to slow you down because you have to expend so much energy just to stay warm. And those joints and those injuries are going to tighten up because it's cold. So you have to have extra layers. If you have to have extra layers, that restricts the movement. That means you can't get that extra gear that you usually have because you're, because you're bundled up and you have extra layers on.
Ian Rappaport started his NFL media career covering the Patriots for the Boston Herald. Let's bring him in now to talk a little more about the Patriots. He's live at NFL headquarters in Park Avenue in New York. A Patriots assistant seems to have a new job waiting for him, Ian.
He does, in fact. It is Brian Flores, the Patriots' defensive play caller, de facto defensive coordinator, someone who came up in the ranks in New England, has been a scout, has been a position coach, now is a key role on that defense. He is the guy the Miami Dolphins want to hire as soon as the Patriots' season ends. That is expected to be completed. So either way, Patriots are going to be looking for a new defensive coordinator next year. Flores is a guy the Dolphins targeted early. They love his presence. They love his command. And by the way, in New England, guys, don't be surprised if Greg Schiano finds a way to end up on that defensive staff, maybe even replacing Flores.
There you go. Flores coming off that Belichick tree, but he's his own guy. We're going to talk plenty about that
right
in the days and weeks to come. Thank you.